Xin anh chờ những quý chỗ.
The President, please be seated.
Veuillez vous asseoir.
Ông chủ nhiệm rè. Các mặt tổ cái
đơn vị. The chamber is now in session.
Nous reprenons l'audience.
Chị Phi Sa, đỉnh đầu, sinh phụ, xã xây.
Today we will hear the testimony.
Aujourd'hui nous allons
of
entendre
Witness Him Huy,
le témoin Him Huy.
Rồn sốt đấy, lục Him Huy.
Good morning, Mr. Him Huy.
Bonjour, Monsieur Him Huy.
Court officer, could you
Je
assist the witness
le témoin
with the hearing equipment?
Pour ce qui est l'utilisation du casque.
Lục Him Huy ta lục ban
phật sa dục bol. Have you consulted with your legal counsel?
Monsieur Him Huy, est-ce que vous avez pu consulter votre conseil juridique?
Yes, I have.
Le témoin. Oui, Monsieur le Président.
The President.
Question.
Do you have any request for your legal counsel to be sitting in the chamber with you?
Souhaitez-vous que votre conseil soit aussi assis dans le prétoire? Réponse.
It's all right with me for the legal counsel to sit in the chamber or not, but it's better if he sits nearby where I sit.
Oui, je suis heureux que le conseil soit assis à proximité.
Would you wish your legal counsel to sit where he is sitting now, or you prefer him to sit outside the courtroom and you would call him when you need his advice?
À l'extérieur du prétoire, sachant que vous pouvez l'appeler si vous avez besoin de ses conseils.
Or you wish to have his presence here in the chamber?
Qu'il soit présent ici dans le prétoire.
During the times that you will be questioned.
Durant votre audition.
And if you are not sure whether your response would lead to self-incrimination and that you need to seek his advice.
Vous risqueriez par vos réponses de vous incriminer vous-même.
It is your choice whether to have his presence during the entire time of your questioning.
C'est à vous qu'il appartient de décider si vous souhaitez sa présence de façon constante ou non.
I would like him to sit in the chamber with me until I finish my testimony.
Dans le prétoire jusqu'au bout de ma déposition, Monsieur le Président.
The
President.
Mr. Him Huy, I would like to inform you that during the time of
Monsieur
your
Huy,
testimony, you have the right to seek
que durant votre déposition,
advice
vous avez
from
le
your
de
legal counsel
auprès de l'avocat qui vous assiste.
If you are not sure whether your response or your statement may self-incriminate you,
vous penseriez que, vos
and
réponses
for
risquent
other
de vous
questions
incriminer.
Which are not dealing or leading to self-incrimination, you do not need to seek his advice.
Pour
you can't respond by yourself.
Pour
therefore, you should only seek his advice when you are not sure
avocat.
Whether your response would lead to self-incrimination. Do you understand?
Il y aura un risque d'auto-incrimination. Est-ce que vous me comprenez bien?
Yes, I do.
Le témoin, oui, je vous comprends.
Mr. Him Huy, can you describe
question, Monsieur
briefly
Him Huy, pouvez-vous décrire brièvement
about the locations and your professions during the time between 1970 until 17 April 1975? What did you do and where were you?
Où vous étiez et ce que vous faisiez?
Him Huy.
Réponse.
Jonas. In 1970, I was a child.
En 1970, j'étais encore un enfant.
And about 10 years old, or 11 years old, I studied in a school.
À l'âge de 10 ou 11 ans, j'étais à l'école.
My apology, I think I made a mistake.
Je crois que je me suis trompé.
From 1970, I already stopped studying.
J'avais déjà arrêté l'école.
I helped my parents with rice farming.
Et j'aidais mes parents qui étaient cultivateurs.
Until 1972 or later 72
jusqu'à la fin de
or early 73
ou début 73.
The chief of the village gathered
village,
those people aged 17 and 18 years old to
17, ans
be a soldier
pour les enrôler.
So all those people within that age were gathered to become
les
the district soldiers.
D'âge, sont donc devenus soldats.
We were provided the training at the Khartoum district.
Dispenser une formation.
But because I missed my parents so much, so I sought permission from the school committee and I lied to them that my mother was sick.
De rentrer. Je leur ai
and
menti,
I was
je leur ai
asked whether I was
malade.
A medic or not to
on
go and treat
si
my mother.
Personnel soignant et capable de soigner ma mère.
I responded that I was
j'ai
not a medic, but my mother was sick, so I would like to visit her for a few hours, then I would return. But I was not authorized to do so.
On ne m'a pas donné cette autorisation.
Later on, my cousin and I, when the training was not on, ran to visit my house. We stayed overnight and returned. And then the school disciplined both of us.
Pour rendre visite à ma famille, nous avons passé la nuit chez moi. Et à notre retour,
we were told
nous sommes passés devant
if a plane dropped a bomb at the school,
un avion
then we too would be shot and killed.
Lâcher une bombe sur l'école, nous
we were given three rifles, and we were asked which rifle
on nous a donné trois fusils, on nous a demandé
wants to have.
Lequel des trois nous
and
voulions
if
garder.
A plane from Pyongyang would fly
si
and drop bombs, we would be tied for the bomb to be dropped on.
And
we were disciplined to carry water
dessus,
to fill all the jars in the
on
school without having any food.
Toutes les jars d'eau de l'école.
During the 3 days period, the plane did not drop the bomb.
Mais pendant trois jours, il n'y a pas eu d'avion et pas de bombe.
Later on, we were transferred
après cela, nous avons été
to
transférés
Preilovir, Prekaba. And at that division, the 12,
dans la division numéro 12,
we were recruited to be part of that division.
C'est ainsi que
those
nous avons été
had big bills were sent into the artillery units and the small bills were used as infantry.
Soldats plus petits étaient versés dans l'infanterie.
I had been a soldier there since then and I
Je suis ainsi resté soldat dans cette division. J'ai reçu une formation militaire et technique.
And then we went into a battle in National Road Number 2.
Et nous avons participé à des combats sur la route
Later
nationale numéro 2.
Later on, we were transferred to National Road
22
to engage in another battlefield.
Où il y avait également des combats.
Subsequently, I was sick and I ran back home.
Malade, je me suis
and also because I missed my parents.
Par ailleurs, mes parents me manquaient toujours.
If the situation was better at the village, then I would stay there. But
si
the situation at the village was not any better,
là,
so I went back to the unit. Then I was sent to the battlefield to fight at the Mekong River battlefield, later on at the Basa River battlefield. Later on, I also sought permission to go and visit my home.
J'ai encore une fois demandé une permission.
And later on, when the situation was intense,
situation
when we were already demoralized, the president, I noticed the presence of the council.
Maître Werner, vous souhaitez parler?
Your Honor, I do apologize for interrupting.
Werner,
I can
oui,
see from here that the witness is reading from a document,
je vois d'ici
and I think it will be wise and to make sense for the judges to know why
si
the
cas,
witness has a document with him, and he apparently is reading from a document. So I would just ask if the judges could inquire about that document.
Quel est ce document qu'il lit exactement? Je vous remercie.
The President, the witness, are you reading from your note as suggested by the civil party lawyer?
Comme semble l'indiquer l'avocat des parties civiles?
Mr. Him Huy,
Monsieur Him Huy,
you have to wait till the red light is on before you can speak. And your voice would be gone through to the interpreters who would subsequently interpret into English and French languages.
Et par les qui
and also, that's for the record of
anglais.
The transcript.
C'est aussi de cette manière que tout ce que vous dites peut être enregistré au fin du compte rendu d'audience.
លោក ហឹម ហួយ និយាយ ដោយ សង្ខេប យើង ចង់ ដឹង ព័ត៌មាន
ដោយ សង្ខេប We want to hear only a summary account of your occupations and your whereabouts during that period. And now you talk about the 73.
Vous étiez en train de nous parler de l'année 73.
Until the 17 April 1975. When the Khmer Rouge troops defeated the Lono regime. So that was one part of the testimonies. When we talked about a brief account, we only want a summary of your whereabouts and your occupations during such time.
Nous ne souhaitons pas de description détaillée de ces événements, mais d'un récit court.
I would like to continue.
Le témoin. Oui, je voudrais poursuivre.
Later on, I wanted to run back home since I was already demoralized.
M'enfuir chez moi parce que j'étais démoralisé.
I already stated that when I was sick, I ran home and I wanted actually to stay and not to come back.
J'avais voulu rentrer chez moi et ne pas revenir.
And when I returned back home, I was asked by the unit of 100, the president, Alain Werner, can you state clearly what you want and what is your request? You have to state clearly your purpose of your submission or remark.
Soyez clair, je vous prie.
I will, and I apologize if I was not clear. I do request the chamber to inquire what is the document that the witness has. My understanding is that the witnesses have to testify without any documents with them. It can be absolutely proper. I'm not inferring anything. I'm just asking the judges to request to understand what is the document, because I can see from here the witness has a document with him. I just request to know what is this document. That's all.
J'aimerais donc savoir quel est ce texte. Et je pense que cela sera utile aussi pour les juges.
The President, Mr. Him Huy, are you reading from a document?
Est-ce que vous êtes en train de lire un texte?
Him Huy.
Le témoin.
What I said is my personal accounts.
Non, ce que j'ai raconté, c'est ce que
je me souviens. Court officer, go and see if there is any document. If there is, remove it.
De s'enquérir de la présence d'un texte ou non et de prendre ce texte si tel est le cas.
President, court officer, these are the documents which were given to him yesterday by the court. It's the records of his interviews before the co-investigating judges.
Des procès-verbaux de ses auditions devant les co-juges d'instruction.
The President, you stated that you joined the army in early 73 in the district soldiers. Which district?
Dans un district, lequel?
Him Huy. During that time, it was called District 18. It's in Korthom of Kondal province.
C'est à Korthom, dans la province de Kandal.
President, after Président. You joined the District
Après
18 soldiers, you said you were recruited into another level of the military. The big build were sent to the artillery, and the small builds were sent to the infantry unit.
À l'artillerie et les soldats
and
plus
what
petits
was the infantry unit called at the time?
Quel était le nom de l'unité d'infanterie à l'époque?
Him Huy.
Réponse.
The infantry unit was 112.
C'était le 112e.
It was a battalion 112.
112e bataillon.
And where were you stationed at the time, asked the president?
Question, où étiez-vous stationné?
We stationed
Réponse.
At Krang Yeo.
Nous étions stationnés à Krang
on Dong Sro Mao and Dombay Slap.
Dombay Slap.
The battalion 112, which
Question.
Division was it under?
Ce 112e bataillon relevait de quelle division?
Asked the president. A response.
Réponse.
It was under a division, I think it was a division 12, but I was not sure yet at the time.
Il appartenait à la 12e division.
Question.
Question.
When you joined the Battalion 112 of Division 12.
Quand vous avez été intégré au 112e bataillon de la 12e division.
Until the 17th April 1975, were you transferred to another battalion or division?
Avez-vous été par la suite transféré à un autre bataillon encore avant le 17 avril 1975? Réponse.
I was transferred in 1974.
Oui, j'ai été transféré en 1974.
Let me clarify that when I was at Battalion 112,
je dois vous expliquer que quand j'étais au 112e
it
bataillon,
was part of the 100 person unit, and in the battlefield,
j'étais dans une unité de 100 personnes.
I was demoralized. I ran home twice.
Sur le front, j'étais démoralisé. Je me suis
Tamon
fui chez moi deux fois.
Not
c'est là que
accept me.
Tamon
and he said I could not be re-educated. So he transferred me to
Tahoe
of the Battalion 112.
Du 112e bataillon pour rééducation.
And Tahoe of the Battalion 112, who was later on became the deputy chairman of Duch.
Du 112e bataillon est le même Or qui est devenu ensuite l'adjoint de Duch.
During the time that you were a soldier during the war of 1975 in the battalion 112 with the commander named Ho,
112e bataillon avec pour commandant Or,
which unit of that battalion you belonged to and what was your assigned task?
Exercer et quelles étaient les tâches qui vous avaient été confiées?
Réponse. When Tamon did not recognize me, then Tahoe took me under his command.
J'ai rejoint l'unité de Tahor.
So I came to work with him at his battalion, and he asked his messenger to send me to Breitoch. And the at Breitoch, they organized an attack unit supervised by Huy Srai, the Huy Srai who later on also worked at
S-21.
Response. What do you mean by the attack force?
Par, force?
Is there any other
offensive?
Name?
Est-ce que cela portait un
response.
Autre nom?
At that time, it
réponse.
Was called in Khmer, Kong Samrok, or the
ça
attack
Kong
force.
Samrok, en Khmer, c'est-à-dire
or
force d'attaque.
Simply, we can call it a special force.
On peut simplement dire force spéciale.
However, during that time, it was known as Gong Samrok or the attack force. Question, how many people in that attack force
unit?
Response, there were 50 or 60 of us in that attack force unit. And in cooperation with the force from the East Zone, there were 50 or 60 of them as well.
Est, ça faisait le double.
The President,
question.
On the 17th of April 1975, what did you do and
fait?
Where did you live?
Et où, que faisiez-vous et où habitiez-vous?
Him Huy.
Réponse.
On 17th of April 1975, I were fighting from Takmao toward Phnom Penh on the national road
number 2
to the glass factory.
Du côté de la verrerie.
President,
question.
Could you please describe briefly?
Pourriez-vous brièvement nous décrire
how you entered Phnom Penh?
Comment?
In 1975,
vous
I mean April 1975, through the
en
road passing the glass factory. And tell us more what had you been doing from that time until 1979.
Un un peu plus ce que vous avez fait depuis ce moment-là jusqu'en 1979.
Him Huy.
Réponse.
I fought along national road from Takmao to Break Kompu
and
toward the glass factory, and we captured the military trucks of the Lonol soldiers with some ammunition, and we arrested one colonel and his son. And they took refuge from the bombardments, from the aerial bombardments, and then we
pour se protéger des bombardements aériens,
reached Phnom Penh, and we
nous
stationed at
Pat
Chen or Yuk Kun Tho High School. And at about 2 or 3 p.m., there was an announcement that all the chiefs of the militaries in Phnom Penh had to surrender. And
Ta
Ho told me to tell the soldiers of Lon Nol at the corner of Sihanouk and Moniwong to surrender. And at about 7 p.m., my units, three groups altogether, were queuing. And then at 8 p.m., there was grenade explosion.
Vers 20h, il y a eu une explosion de grenade.
I don't know whether it's the explosion of M72 or not, but the bomb exploded and a lot of people died or wounded.
The
wounds sustained from the blast, and we escaped from the scene.
Nous avons pu nous échapper.
The president. Mr. Him Huy, do you know S21 security office?
Est-ce que vous connaissez le bureau de sécurité S21?
Him Huy, yes, I do.
Oui, réponse, oui.
The president, did you ever work or live in that security office S21?
Avez-vous résidé dans ce bureau de sécurité S21?
Him Huy,
réponse,
yes,
oui.
I did. I worked at S21.
Travaillais.
The president.
Question.
When did you start working at S21 and who introduced you to that office?
Vous a recruté à S21.
Him Huy.
Réponse.
After the fall of 1975,
la prise de Phnom Penh en
1975, our unit was asked to work to build dikes at the electricity department somewhere near Chak Ang Rae. Later on, we were sent to work as rice farmers at Prek Chreu. And we mainly worked with farmings. The president, you have already mentioned in details, it is not what we are looking for. We want brief accounts. The chamber would not want to listen to the details of your story now because we are now asking the particular questions concerning the facts at issue. So we would like to know when you were sent to S21, when did you start working there, and who recruited you, or how could you get to work at the S21? This is the question.
Par quel processus avez-vous abouti à S21?
Him Huy, was at Prek Chreu.
J'étais à Prek Chreu.
Was asked to transfer my unit. At about 8 p.m., I was taken to S21. And I asked him what's wrong that I was being taken to that location, and I was told by him that I would know when I got there. And then I was left at that prison for a few days, and later on I was made to guard the complex. And by late 1976, I think at the time I came in to Phnom Penh to work at the S21, the president. So in 1976, Ho was the person who recruited or who assigned you to work at S21. Is that correct? Him, Huy. It was not the one-eyed Ho. It was another Ho, the short Ho.
Le petit Ho.
The president. When you start working at S21, do you recall the original name of your workplace? Was it Office 21 or was there other name used? Him Huy. It was S21 from the very beginning. The president. Do you know S21 very clear, and can you locate it if you are asked to locate the complex? And please answer. I think I can, said Him Huy. Now the office is named Tuol Slang. President, is it the Tuol Slang Museum?
Vous parlez du musée de Tuol Slang?
Him Huy, yes, there is.
Réponse, oui.
The president, when you were sent to work at the S21 security office, what was the assignment assigned to you back then?
Mission?
Him Huy. I was the combatant, and I was on guard at the complex to guard on the detainees. And later on, I was assigned to receive prisoners at the location where there was a radio communication, now the Sombokmom radio station.
The president,
through your recollection, within the entire S21 unit, who was the chairman, overall chairman, and who was the deputy chairman?
Le patron, le directeur, et qui en, et qui
Him
était son
Huy.
Adjoint.
For the defense unit,
pour ce qui est de l'unité
there were
de
a few
défense,
chiefs,
il y avait plusieurs chefs.
The chief of the unit of 100,
le chef de l'unité.
There were 10 of them.
Il y avait en fait 10 chefs.
There were about 10 of them, correction. The president, I'm asking about the overall chairman, or
question.
We call it the
non,
committee of S21.
De la direction.
Are you familiar with the name of such committee?
Et puis il y avait un comité de S21. Savez-vous ce qu'il en était de ce comité?
Him Huy.
Connaissez-vous son existence?
I have never heard of such a committee. I have heard that there was a chairman of S21 and the deputy chairman and staff member. The president, when you started working at S21, my question is whether
c'est
you know who would have been the chairman of the S21. I'm talking about the chief of S21, not the chief of the unit of 100. Do you recall
d'unité.
Who he was
est-ce
or
que
she
vous
was?
Saviez à ce moment-là?
Him Huy, the
réponse.
Chairman of S21
le directeur
was
S21
Doik. And Ho, or Ta Ho, was the deputy chairman Tahar and était other subordinates.
Son adjoint. Et il y avait d'autres cadres.
The president, you were talking about Huy. What would be his full name and where did he work at S21?
De Huy. Quel était son nom?
Him Huy. At the beginning, we called him Brother Big Huy. He was the member of S21 who worked at Presor.
Le membre de S21 qui travaillait à Presor.
The president, you said you were made to work as the guard
vous a fait
at the location where there was a radio communication, now the Tombokmom radio station,
la station radio Tombokmom
located somewhere
qui se trouve
near the fire department.
De la station de pompiers.
What was your unit called?
Votre unité à vous s'appelait comment?
Him Huy.
Réponse.
Our unit was called the unit to receive
detainees
and to transfer or transport detainees who already been interrogated to Chiang Hek.
Transport des détenus déjà interrogés vers Chiang Hek.
President, have you ever heard the special unit?
Avez-vous déjà entendu parler d'une chose qu'on appelait l'unité spéciale? Réponse.
I think every one of us called it a special unit, but of course they belong to the defense unit.
Cela faisait partie en fait de l'unité de défense.
The president, was the defense unit divided into inside defense or outside defense?
En unité de défense interne et de défense externe, par exemple. Réponse.
People who were assigned to guard inside were different from those who were assigned to guard outside.
Dans l'enceinte n'étaient pas les mêmes que ceux qui étaient
the president,
à l'extérieur, qui gardaient.
You said you were assigned
l'extérieur.
To arrest, to receive and
on
to transport and to smash detainees, as what you have just mentioned.
Des détenus et à leur transport
how
vers
many
Chiang
people
et à leur élimination,
were there
après ce que
in
vous avez expliqué,
that
combien de personnes
section
travaillaient
or
dans
unit.
Cette section?
And in each section, what would be the sub-sections? And how many people were in those sub-sections, if there were? Him Huy.
Unités qui en faisaient partie.
When people, when we were assigned to arrest people outside, then people from the defense would be borrowed to assist us in the arrest operation.
De l'équipe de défense pour nous prêter main forte afin de procéder
President.
À ces arrestations. Question.
So in total, how many
Donc,
people
total,
were in your group?
Il y avait combien de membres de votre groupe?
Him Huy.
Réponse.
The group to receive detainees,
le groupe de
to transport
des
them,
et de transport
there were 10 of
Hek
us.
Comportait 10 employés ou 10 membres.
The president.
Question.
You said you received orders
vous avez
to
dit que vous avez
make
reçu
arrests
l'ordre
of people from different places under the direction of
Hor,
who were the deputy,
qui était
and that the guards from other defense who was strong built would be borrowed to assist you.
De l'unité de défense
during such operation, while Hor was directing
forte,
your team, where were the arrests made? Were they made in Phnom Penh, or were the arrests also extended to other zones or various parts of the country? And how often were
et à quelle fréquence est-ce que cela se produisait?
Him Huy. We want to arrest people in Battambang province, but of course we only want there to receive the people who had been arrested for us already. At Swirieng province, we also want there to make arrest of the Vietnamese soldiers who had been captured in the battlefields. At Kampong Saum, we also want to receive and transport the people who had been arrested already under the order and direction of Ta Ho. I went with Paul, the chief of the guard unit.
De la section des gardes.
President. You said about transportation.
Vous avez
you said about arrest. Now,
vous
I would like to keep the matter of arrest apart a little bit.
Alors,
while we touch upon the transportation of detainees. So when you were assigned to transport people in those locations, for example, Battambang, Huai Rieng, and Kampong Saum, how many people would be involved in going to transport the detainees, and how were they transported,
and
in each time, how many people would be loaded
occasion,
on
the
truck or whatever used during that
votre
time?
Véhicule, ou vos véhicules.
Him Huy, when we went to Battambang, there was two Land Rover vehicles. And when we went to Kampong Saum, we took only one Land Rover vehicle with about 4 to 5 people along with Paul. And when we went to Swai Rieng, there were just very few of us with a driver to make to transport the detainees. The President, one Land Rover vehicle was used to carry those detainees. So how many detainees would be loaded on such one vehicle? Can you estimate the number of people who could be loaded on such each Land Rover at a time?
Combien de personnes pouvaient être chargées sur une Land Rover à la fois?
Him Huy.
Réponse.
One Land Rover could accommodate
sur une Land Rover, nous
6 to 7 detainees at a time.
À la fois.
And then along with the guards, 4 to 5 guards, some would be standing on the front and some at the rear of the Land Rover.
D'autres à l'arrière de la Land Rover.
When we went to Battambang, we took two vehicles because it was a long distance.
Parce que c'était une distance considérable.
How
question.
People were arrested or transported from Battambang, from Swai Rieng, or from other special sectors like Kampong Saum to S21.
Pour être transporté vers S21.
How was it managed?
Alors comment est-ce que
how were the detainees treated?
Comment
were they shackled? Were they
est-ce que les détenus étaient entravés, avaient les yeux bandés?
Could you please tell the court how they were treated during the time when they were being transported from those locations to S21?
Pendant que les détenus étaient transportés de ces différents endroits vers S21.
Him
réponse.
Huy. When we reached the locations where the detainees would have been
lorsque
arrested already, then
nous
the blindfold would be put on the detainees, and then
arrêtés,
they would be shackled.
Le
and when we approached them,
les entraves aux pieds,
then there were handcuffs, automatic handcuffs would be put, and then the hands of the detainee would be put to behind their backs, and then we walked them across the road and upload them on the trucks,
dos,
and we put them to lie down on the sit down on the truck, the vehicle before
véhicule,
we transported
assis
them.
Sur le
the President, were there any wooden shackles or metal bars
question,
used as shackles
des
to
bar ou des
be put on the detainees during the course of transportation? I mean, apart from the detainees being blindfolded and handcuffed, were there wooden shackles or metal bar? Him Huy. After detainees were already shackled,
they
would not be put further shackles, actually.
On
and the guards were very vigilant. They had
to be alert
at all times until
moment.
The detainees were
jusqu'à
sent to S21.
L'arrivée à
President,
question.
From Battambang to Phnom Penh,
I
think it is about 300 kilometers. And during the time of the war, the roads were, I believe, not in good condition as it would have been bombarded by aerial bombardments and by floods or natural causes, so it would take longer to reach Battambang and to return to S21. So what or how the detainees relieve themselves if you actually or if they were actually handcuffed or their hands were tied and cuffed behind their backs?
Menottés avec les bras derrière le dos en particulier. Réponse.
While we were traveling on the long distance road,
detainees
were not allowed to relieve themselves because we were afraid that they would abscond. So whatever they could relieve themselves while being tied up, then they could take the advantage of the time when they were being tied up and that the guards would not allow them to get away to relieve themselves.
Comme ils pouvaient, tout en restant attachés.
The president. I think you proceeded further beyond what we were about to ask. But then when you talked about the transportation of the Vietnamese prisoner of war in Svai Rieng, do you remember when this operation took place?
En fait, vous souvenez-vous
I mean, when the Vietnamese soldiers
lieu,
were arrested and transported to S21, and who ordered
quand?
Such transportation, and how
et
often did you go there to transport the Vietnamese soldiers, and how many soldiers were transported each time?
Et à chaque fois, combien de soldats étaient transportés?
Him Huy. There were two times we transported those Vietnamese soldiers.
Pardon.
There were 15 Vietnamese soldiers
et ils étaient 15 soldats
each
vietnamiens
time.
À la fois.
The president, who ordered you
question,
to transport
ce transport
them.
S'était réalisé sur les ordres de qui?
Him Huy.
Réponse.
Ta Duch, through his messenger,
Ta Duch par
told me
de son messager,
to transport the prisoners, the Vietnamese prisoners in Svai Rieng.
Transporter
President,
les soldats vietnamiens de
when
Svai Rieng à S21.
Traveled
question.
To
lorsque
transport prisoners
vous étiez ainsi
in
en déplacement pour le transport de prisonniers depuis Battambang Svai Rieng,
Kampong
Saum,
were you given any letter,
vous étiez
travel permit or
laissez-passer,
for example,
sauf-conduit
and who actually issued such letter and who signed on it to allow you to go out and transport those detainees.
Afin de vous donner l'autorisation de procéder à ce transport.
Him Huy.
Réponse.
The letter was given to me from Ta Ho with the signature of Son Sen on it.
Son Sen.
The president.
Question.
Now we would go back a little bit to the early statement that you said Hall ordered the operation, the arrest operation from other locations to be transported to S21 office in Phnom Penh.
Fallait transporter jusqu'à S21 à Phnom Penh.
So in the arrest operation,
dans ces opérations,
my question is,
voici ma question.
Dans well, just now we said, we talked about transportation, I mean the people who had already been arrested and you were assigned to only collect them or transport them from those locations to S21.
Seulement de les transporter vers S21. Vous n'aviez pas eu à les arrêter.
Now we would like to ask you about the order to go out and make arrests.
De savoir ce qu'il en était des ordres que vous receviez pour aller procéder à des arrestations.
The location of Phnom Penh,
est-ce que
or were you also ordered to make arrests of people in other zones
aussi dans
as
d'autres
well?
Zones?
Him Huy.
Réponse.
The arrests were made at Psa Thamay, or Central Market now,
nous les avons fait
and
à
ordered
Thamay,
by Ta Hor, and we
sur
would
Ta
regrouped ourselves
nous nous
to conduct such arrests, and the arrests would be made at night at that location.
Se faisait de nuit au Psa Thamay. Question.
The President, did you receive the order
est-ce que vous
orally
un ordre oral
or
pour
through
ce,
any written
pour se faire, ou bien
order?
Est-ce que vous aviez un ordre de coucher sur un document?
Him Huy, Deutsch would
réponse,
order me through Tahor to
par
make such arrests.
De procéder
President.
À ces arrestations. Question.
So in your operation, you
donc,
went with
dans
Hall, who was the deputy, who was your immediate supervisor,
Hall,
is that correct?
Supérieur immédiat, c'est cela?
Yes, that's correct, Your Honor.
Réponse, oui, c'est correct.
The President, when arrest was made at Psa Thamay, how many people were arrested?
Cela faisait combien de
Him
personnes?
Huy.
Combien de personnes arrêtiez-vous?
I don't remember, I only recollected the operation conducted at night.
Cette opération a été réalisée
the President,
de nuit.
Did you also
question,
go out to arrest more people other than people at Psa Thamay?
Est-ce que vous êtes aussi allé arrêter des gens ailleurs qu'à Psa Thamay?
Him Huy.
Réponse.
There was other arrests. When people returned from France, then
exemple,
the city messenger
France,
gave
ville,
us the message that we
message
had to receive, you know, a lot of more people, like at four or five people at a time, and in several occasions.
De détenus, quatre ou cinq détenus à la fois.
Question.
Et cela,
so the receiving of order and the
question.
Conduct of
donc,
the operations outside, as you claimed,
des ordres
led by
Ho,
who was the deputy chairman of S21.
Sous la responsabilité de Ho, le directeur adjoint de S21.
Did you conduct operations outside Phnom Penh, avez-vous I mean at various sectors and zones.
Avez-vous mené des opérations d'arrestation en dehors de Phnom Penh, dans différents autres secteurs ou zones?
Response.
Réponse.
Mostly the arrests were made in Phnom Penh.
La plupart de nos arrestations se faisaient dans Phnom Penh.
Question. When you went to make an arrest in Phnom Penh without having proper documentation or photographs, did you ever make any wrong arrest? Or how did you identify the targets before making the arrest? Response. We were instructed already before we made the arrest. When we arrived at the location, there was a cadre or two cadres.
Cadres.
who already organized a group of those people to be arrested.
Qui avait déjà
so we were shown those people that we need to make the arrest.
Les gens qu'il fallait arrêter.
Question, any indication or signs instructed to you to make the arrest? Response.
Qu'aviez-vous comme indication,
réponse. The two cadres who were sitting together, we would not arrest them. We would only arrest those people who sat a bit further from each other. They were the targets of the arrest.
C'était eux les cibles.
Question. So it means the operation led by Ho in conducting the arrest. You did not go to make arrest outside Phnom Penh area, is this correct?
Que Or était responsable des arrestations et que vous n'avez pas été hors de Phnom Penh pour passer les
arrestations. When we went to the countryside, we did not make the arrest. We only went to receive those people who were already arrested. Sometimes Peng also went with me. Sometimes I went with Ho.
Parfois Peng y allait et parfois j'y allais avec Or.
Question, you just said that you stationed at a house.
Vous venez de dire que vous étiez
with the radio communication, which is now known as the Beehive radio station.
À proximité de ce que l'on connaît aujourd'hui comme la station
and
de radio
it
Beehive.
Is currently on street 360.
Rue 360.
Near the vicinity to the east
tout près
of the fire station.
À l'est de la station de pompiers.
The duty of the guards at that location, what were the main duties?
Quelles étaient les principales responsabilités des gardes qui se trouvaient là?
Response. The duties of the guards at that location, for example, in my unit, we waited to receive the prisoners which were to be sent and not to allow that car to enter the compound. We would be responsible if the car would enter the compound because this is a secret location. Another duty besides this
autre
responsabilité, is to wait to receive the prisoners who would be sent to our location or when we had to go to make the arrest. And besides that, we also raise the poultry.
Aussi aller à l'extérieur
question.
Pour chercher les prisonniers et enfin, nous
you just
de la
stated
volaille.
That the duties of your group is to stay was
question.
To station at that
vous
location
que
and if people were sent to you
vous étaient envoyés,
first, those people were arrested, tied, and cuffed.
D'abord arrêtés, entravés, menottés.
And another duty was to receive those people who were sent from various units.
Les gens qui venaient de différentes unités.
Meaning, those people had already been arrested
que dans ce cas,
and sent to you just for the
et
transfer from their units. And then your team would send them into inside a compound. Is this a fair description?
Et de les faire entrer dans l'enceinte de la
respond.
Prison.
That is correct.
C'est une description exacte de ce que vous faisiez? Réponse, oui, c'est exact.
Question. Can you talk further about the city messengers who frequently arrested those people who arrived from abroad?
Aux arrestations des gens qui venaient de l'étranger.
How those people were sent?
Comment se faisait le transfert de ces gens? Est-ce qu'ils étaient menottés?
Or were they were not cuffed? And how was your operation of arrest of those people
à l'arrestation
and
de ces personnes?
Brought them into the S21 office?
Comment les faisiez-vous entrer?
Response before the arrest, we were informed earlier
avant
that those people who arrived from abroad
des étrangers
would need to be arrested
allaient être arrêtés.
And then they left. And then they would transport those people to the
et
house where we stationed
partaient,
and we prepared our force to arrest those people. And information was given to us by Ho and Deutsch. And the person who came to inform us was Paul. When the time to be sent, that those people to be sent to the location response. So there were two sources of information that you received. One was the instruction from Deutsch and his deputy, Paul, to prepare your force in order to receive those people. And another source was to receive the information from the city messenger, namely Bong, who came directly to inform you that there will be people who would be sent to your location with the exact numbers.
Et vous précisez le nombre de ces personnes.
Is this a fair description?
Est-ce que c'est exact?
Response, yes.
Réponse, oui.
Question. And the messenger, when the city messenger sent those people, were they already tied or cuffed? Or they were not, and they used a different method to trick them to be sent to your location, and only upon arriving at your location that they would be arrested. Response, when they were sent to my location, they were not yet arrested, they were lied to go to another work location. So they came along, and at my location, because we already made arrangements, they were asked to enter the room to sit at a table, and then we would make the arrest.
Question.
The city messenger sent those people to your location, as you stated, and Bong was the coordinator between the city messenger office and S21. How many cases of such account happened when people were sent by the city messengers, especially those people who arrived from abroad? How many of them?
Réponse.
There were a lot of them. They were students from France, for instance.
De gens. Il y a eu des étudiants rentrés de
France. I cannot recall the exact number, that there were a large number of them.
En grand
question.
Nombre.
So every time they were sent, they question. Were transported in a vehicle
donc
to the location where you stationed. Is this correct?
L'endroit où vous étiez stationné, c'est exact?
Response, that is correct.
Réponse. Oui, c'est exact. Interprète corrige, il ne s'agit pas d'étrangers, mais de Cambodgiens rentrés de l'étranger.
In other cases,
question.
When you receive the people who have been arrested from various units, including the military units or various departments or ministries in the city, or when they were sent from various sectors or zones, how were those people transported to you? Was the same means used as those used by the city messengers? Or were those people already handcuffed and blindfolded when they arrived at your location?
Avait déjà response. Les yeux bandés et les mains menottées lorsqu'il vous arrivait.
It's different.
Réponse.
Through the ministries and the military units, they were differently when those people were sent to S21.
Il y avait une procédure différente pour envoyer
question,
les gens à S21.
Question, can you elaborate further on the differences?
Réponse, est-ce que vous pouvez nous en dire plus sur cette procédure différente?
Between the various units? Response.
Réponse.
For example, for the military unit,
exemple,
the division 310,
voilà,
when they sent
division,
those people whom they arrested, they would transport those people by themselves to the location. Also, from when people were arrested from various other units, they were cuffed already when they were sent to my location.
Ils arrivaient déjà
questions. Besides the city messengers group,
en dehors du groupe,
was there any trick or means used to trick those people who would later be arrested to tell lies to them
est-ce
without having to handcuff or blindfold them?
Est-ce qu'on les
and then later on, they would be arrested at your location.
Leur
was such means used by any other groups besides the city messenger group?
Cet artifice a été utilisé pour d'autres personnes que ceux envoyés par le messager
Response,
de la
ville. Yes, there
Réponse,
was.
Réponse, oui.
People were tricked to be sent to my location and then they would be arrested.
On nous envoyait des gens
Question.
Qui
so in summary, your group
Question. Donc,
who
résumé,
were assigned to station at a location in order to receive the people
à cet endroit pour réceptionner
and there were two types
les gens qu'on
envoyait of those people.
One
group of those people, they were tricked
il y avait ceux
and they were told that they were transferred to another workplace and when they arrived at your location then the operation of arrest commenced. And another group, their respective units already arrested them and transported them to your location in order to send them inside the compound. Is this a fair description?
En passant par
Response,
votre
yes.
Bureau de réception. Est-ce une description exacte? Réponse oui.
Question.
Question.
In the operation of receiving those people, how did your unit operate? You only operated during the daytime? Or also you operated during the night?
De jour
and
ou
if
aussi de nuit?
You worked during the night, at what time you finished?
Et si vous travaillez aussi de nuit,
there was no fixed time for such operation in receiving those people.
Pour ce qui est de réceptionner des
Response.
Gens. Réponse.
There was no fixed time.
Il n'y avait pas d'horaire fixe.
To work or to rest. We worked continually and irregularly.
Stable.
Response. Question. So it means
question.
You worked day and night as long as the operation was required. Is this correct?
En fonction des besoins opérationnels.
Response. Yes.
Réponse. Oui.
The operation of making the arrest or the receiving the people or the sending them into the compound, we only did it when we received instructions from the upper echelons. Besides, we would just arrest poultry.
Quand on recevait des instructions en ce
Question.
Sens.
So your team
s'occupait de la volaille.
Did not just
Question.
Stand or sit
Donc,
there permanently, but your operation was dependent on the instructions from the upper echelon. For example, if you had to receive people, then you would
que vous deviez ou non recevoir des
stay there to receive those people, regardless of the time of the day.
Et cela, quel que soit
and you had to
la nuit.
Accomplish the instructions, the order. Is this correct?
Vous mettre en action
Response,
lorsque vous en
yes, it is
l'instruction.
Correct.
Réponse, oui, c'est exact.
Questioned. What about the place where you stayed, or where your group stayed? Where did your group stay at the time?
Où
or you also stayed at that same location?
Votre groupe. Est-ce que vous étiez
you mean where you slept?
Au même endroit. J'entends par là. Où est-ce que vous dormiez?
During
vous
your
logé?
Daily living? Response.
Réponse.
The location where we received and those people was also the location where we stayed and lived permanently.
Notre lieu d'hébergement permanent.
Question.
Question.
Now you are talking about the process of making the arrest or of receiving the arrest or the receiving of those people who had been arrested already and that your group was stationed there in order to receive them and to send those people inside the buildings, the detention buildings
dans le centre de détention,
within the compound of S21.
Dans l'enceinte
How was the daily operation like?
À quoi ressemblait cette activité quotidienne?
Response.
Réponse.
When people who were arrested or who had been arrested and transported to us,
lorsque nous arrêtions des gens ou réceptionnions des gens qui avaient déjà été arrêtés,
they would be sent inside the detention buildings within the compound. So they were sent to Brother Souti,
on les faisait passer
and Brother
Souti
would
Sousti.
Register
Sousti
their names.
Était celui qui enregistrait leur nom.
Then they would be sent to the photography
Après,
section where they would be photographed and with the serial number displayed
photo,
on the photographs
qui comporte aussi
and later
un,
on
un numéro.
Thie would ensuite, deliver them to Peng, and Peng would assign them to various rooms or individual cells.
Dans des cellules collectives
question.
Individuelles.
Question. So, your unit operation was to transfer those people from that location,
transiter les gens,
which was your base station, in order to receive them,
de votre station
and then you
réception.
Send them to a location where those people would be questioned on their own biographies, and later on they would be photographed, and then you would
leur photo,
take your group back.
Après quoi, votre or groupe
was your group still waiting to send those people inside the various rooms or individual cells?
Est-ce que votre,
or
est-ce
was
que vos hommes accompagnaient
this
les
the task of another unit or group?
Ou est-ce que c'était là une tâche confiée à d'autres?
Response.
Réponse.
When my group sent those people into the Souti's office, where they would be questioned on their biography and photographs, and after that, the Peng's force would send them into the individual cells. Question. So, the change of the group was at a location. Where the where Suti who registered their names and where the prisoners were photographed. So the exchange of force was at that location, and then the internal unit would take those prisoners into the room, and you would take your force back. Is this correct?
Response.
Yes, that is correct.
Question.
Regarding the process of sending those people from the location, it means your group's location, which is now the Beehive radio station, until they were sent to the office inside, where they would be handed over to another group.
Les prisonniers à un autre groupe.
How the process was done? Were they transported in a vehicle or were they walked?
Ou est-ce que
and if so, how was it conducted? And for example, in the case of a few prisoners and in the case of a large group of prisoners, how did your group organize this?
Et comment cela se passait-il selon qu'il s'agissait d'un petit groupe de prisonniers ou d'un groupe plus grand?
Those people who were arrested, and if they were sent in large number, and after they were already arrested, then a rope would be used to hook through their arms, and they would be walked into the prison.
Ensemble par une corde, et
and actually they were blindfolded, so they could not see anything. And sometimes, when the prisoners were sent en masse,
parfois,
they would be sent into the prisons. They would be called to go up into the house, and they would be locked from the outside. They would be ordered to strip off their clothes,
dans une maison,
and
on
they could not protest against
et,
the guards. Ils n'avaient
pas la possibilité de protester.
Question. Those people who arrived at your location,
ces gens qui arrivaient,
and then your force was responsible for them
était prise en charge par vos hommes.
In sending them or in handing over them
qui
to the group inside in order to detain them.
De garde interne.
What was the maximum number of group of people that you ever received?
De gens que vous ayez jamais reçu d'un coup.
Response. The largest
réponse.
Number at a time
le
was
grand groupe
50 to 60.
Devait faire 50 à 60 personnes.
But when they were delivered inside the prison, they would be allowed or ordered to walk one by one.
Mais à
question.
De la prison,
we want to know when
un par un.
They were at your station.
Je parle ici du moment
at your base, and when they were walked by your groups to the sortie group. So what was the maximum number of them at the time?
Quel était le nombre maximum
response
de gens?
When people were transferred to them, the large number would be 50 to 60.
On pouvait en
and
prendre
then
maximum
we would
ou
use a rope to hook
et
their arms.
Une corde pour les
and because they were in large number and there were only a few people in my group, then we would walk them with that rope to Suti's group. Question, so you use the rope to walk them into that building. How many of people in your group to walk those large group of people?
Ainsi un groupe aussi grand?
Response. For large group, when we use the rope,
quand nous utilisions la corde,
there would be six or seven of us to hold those ropes to make them tight and not loose. And then we would order them to turn left or right.
Qui donnait l'instruction de tourner
question.
À gauche ou à droite.
So you mean there would be one
question.
Of your men who led them in front
qui,
by holding the rope
tête pour tirer la
in
corde
order to lead them.
De façon
is this correct?
À diriger le groupe. Est-ce exact?
Response. One would lead
réponse.
Them, otherwise the prisoner would not know where to walk.
Parce que sinon, les prisonniers n'auraient pas su.
And then there would be people on the side in order
et
to make
côtés,
sure the rope was tight and not loose. And then
bien
they would order the prisoners to turn left or right.
Aux prisonniers aussi, de tourner à gauche ou à droite.
Question. In studying the case file, there was a point that a large number of
du dossier, il apparaît que
people who were the military cadres
il y a eu un jour un grand groupe qui est arrivé de cadres militaires
of the East Zone,
de la zone Est,
whom were transferred
lesquels ont
to
été
S21 office,
à S21.
And they were in large number, there were 300 of them. Did your base or your location ever receive 300 people in one group in a day? If it existed, how did your group manage to send them or to walk them from your location to the group who waits to receive them inside the compound?
Jusqu'à l'intérieur de l'enceinte de S21.
Réponse. When they were sent in large group, they would be stopped at my location and then we would ask the drivers to get off and then my men would drive those vehicles into the compound.
Qui conduisaient les camions pour faire entrer les prisonniers dans l'enceinte.
Question. So you said that all the operations were instructed by Dutch, the chairman of S21, and he ordered Ho, and subsequently all the Ho would order your group in order to implement the instructions. And in some cases, Ho also participated in the operations. He directly led the operation in the name as the deputy. And did you know how were the orders delivered from Deutsch to Ho? Was it verbal or written?
Est-ce que vous savez si les ordres que donnait Duc à Ho étaient
I did not know about that.
Ou verbalement? Réponse, non, je ne sais pas.
Because these two people had their own telephone. I did not know whether they communicated via the telephone or by a written note sent through their messengers.
Question.
And your team, you received a direct order from the deputy,
or
did you receive orders for the operations
directly
from the accused Dutch?
De Duc, concernant vos opérations.
A response.
réponse.
We receive most of the orders from Ho because Ho was my direct superior,
and
Deutsch was the superior of Ho. He would order Ho, and Ho would order us.
Or, qui à son tour nous donnait des instructions.
Question: did you ever receive direct order from the accused,
Deutsch?
Réponse. I also receive orders from
des instructions de Duc.
Question. In what circumstances can you elaborate further on the situation when you receive direct orders from Duc?
Concernant ces ordres directs que vous avez reçus de Duc.
Réponse. Sometimes he ordered me to go to Swairing to transport those Vietnamese soldiers who were arrested. It was his direct order.
Transporter des soldats vietnamiens. Ça, c'est un ordre direct de Duc.
Question. During the time that you worked at S21 office in Phnom Penh,
pendant la période où vous avez travaillé à S21
Phnom Penh, did you receive any information or learned of the situation?
Des informations, ou est-ce que vous avez eu connaissance
when Deutsch himself,
de situation
as the chairman of S21,
en tant que directeur conduct de S21,
his personal arrest? It means he himself personally made the arrest. Were you aware of such assistance?
Est-ce que vous avez connaissance d'incidents de ce genre? Réponse, oui.
But he himself,
mais
he did not personally make arrest.
Duc n'a pas procédé personnellement aux arrestations.
He ordered other people like my group to make the arrest, or to order Payne and Paul's groups to make the arrest as well.
Ou donner ses ordres aux hommes, aux groupes, plutôt
que relever
de
in what cases that he personally ordered the
question, dans
arrest?
Quel cas a-t-il
we are here talking about the order for the arrest.
Nous parlons ici d'ordre.
And we do not talk about any other facts.
Concernant
we
des
only talk about the facts in relation to the making the arrest. So you said he did not personally make the arrest, but he would order other groups or your group to make the arrest. Can you elaborate further on this?
De procéder à des arrestations. Est-ce que vous pouvez nous en dire un peu plus?
Réponse. He would call us to be instructed at his house.
Il nous convoquait chez lui dans sa maison pour nous donner des instructions.
Question.
Question.
Whom you said the city messenger,
Pong,
who,
le messager,
who
le coursier
would
de la ville,
bring those people from abroad and handed those people to you in order for you to
de
deliver them into the prison. Are you talking about that
faire
Pong?
À la prison. C'est de ce Pong là que vous
response.
Parlez.
That was
maintenant.
Pong.
Réponse. Ça c'est Pong.
Whom we received instruction to arrest him. Question: you talk about the operation of arresting Pong. How was it done?
Nous avons reçu l'ordre d'arrêter Pong. Question: comment cela s'est-il passé?
Response: for the arrest of Pong, we were instructed to arrest one important person, that was Pong, and we were instructed on the exact time that he would arrive, so we concealed ourselves. And when he came to his house on a motorbike, he came and sit with him, and then we made the arrest.
Question.
So it means you already made the arrangement of the target to be arrested, that was Pong. And the arrest was made when Pong arrived at his house. So you were instructed that after he arrived, after he sat with him, then you would proceed with the arrest. Were there any code or symbols to be used in order to signal the appropriate time for the arrest? or only you discussed and you were instructed beforehand before his arrival?
Des instructions autres qui étaient données auparavant.
Him Huy.
Réponse.
Actually, we already discussed this with some kind of signals agreed. After a brief sitting, then the person was arrested.
C'est donc assise, restée assise un bref instant, et nous avons procédé à l'arrestation.
President.
Question.
What about the arrest of Huy Srai? You called him Big Huy. Do you know anything about the arrest of Huy Srai, who was the member of the S21 committee, the man who worked at Presor?
C'est lui qui dirigeait les opérations après Sor. Comment a-t-il été arrêté?
Him Huy.
Réponse.
I was at Trường Ác while Huy Srai was being arrested. I was
l'arrestation de Huy Srai.
Called by Taho, and there were the groups of Peng in Phnom Penh and Bu and Toi who actually went together to arrest him.
Pour
before we reached him, then he was already arrested
avant que je n'arrive sur les lieux, en fait, il avait déjà été
near Lon Nol's house. The president, where was Lon Nol's house located?
Où était la maison de Lon Nol?
It was located at Sla Ku.
Elle se trouvait à Sla Ku.
The president.
Question.
So Nol Huy or Huy Srai, the member of S21 committee, was arrested at the former Lon Nol's house at Sla Ku,
or called Ba Ku. Autrement appelé Ba Ku.
The question is, was the accused Deutsch present at that time? Him Huy.
Réponse.
I don't think I paid any attention to his presence because I was so worried by myself already that Him Huy was arrested, so I think time would come that I would be arrested too, because when I was
j'ai pensé que le, mon tour
there, that Huy implicated me that I would stage a rebellion, and later on they found out that I had a gun, that I would be staging such a rebellion. So
Tapan
from Division 703, who was detained and interrogated, he implicated Hor. So I was so scared that when Huy Srai was arrested, one day I would to be arrested because of the implications Huy Srai would make
about me. Parce que Huy Srai donnerait mon nom.
Mr. President. Since
question.
The witness is moved by the latest account, and since it is time to take an adjournment, the chamber would like to take 18-minute adjournment.
We
will resume at 10 to 11 to continue hearing the testimony of this witness. The court official is now directed to make sure that the witness is taken to his waiting room and return him before during that time, 10 to 11.
11h-10.